Welcome to my channel. This is Dawn with Peak Chair Gaming, and this is day 14 of my 30-day challenge to try and create a 5-star island in just 30 in-game days without any time traveling. And today we have our 8th villager now on the island, and it is Bruce. And let's get right to it and welcome him to the island. He is probably one of my absolute favorite villagers. There is no way I was leaving him on the island. He is absolutely adorable. I love him to death. Okay, so with that in mind, and I was trying to figure out, oh, we have Gullivar. I don't think I've had him yet. Alright, so with that in mind, that means that we should now have enough villagers to get to 3 stars. So let's go ahead and check in with Isabel and let's see where we're at, because if we don't have 3 stars, I may go ahead and get another villager to go villager hunting, just so we can get the flowers off of the island. Because usually if I don't have 3 stars, it's because there's not enough flowers, because I feel like I have enough items decorating the island. I could be wrong. We'll just have to wait and see what she says, especially if it's not 3 stars, but I'm really hoping it is. So let's not dilly-dally any longer and go see what she says. Oh my gosh, I cannot believe I actually got 3 stars on the first try. I really was worried about it, that I would not have enough flowers, but it looks like we accomplished that feat. So let me get through the rest of this conversation. It'll be tomorrow before KK comes and visits, and we can actually start like doing terraforming and stuff like that. But I am super happy with that, with the rating. Oh my gosh, I'm speechless. Yeah, I'm super happy with the 3-star rating. That means it took us literally half the challenge to get to where we could start decorating. So we have 15 more days after tomorrow to decorate the island. But anyway, for now, let me get through all of this conversation. I will probably go ahead and check with the ABD while I'm in here, and then we'll go check in with Nook's Cranny and Able Sisters and see what we can get into for today. Okay, let's see what Nook's Cranny's got. Ooh, they have a stove. I will take that. That is a good item to have. I just got an upgrade on my house, so now I have the front, like the big room in the front. I have the room in the back, and I have the room to the left. And I may go ahead and turn that into a kitchen area. So yeah, that would be kind of neat. Alright, I'm going to see what they have in the cabinet, and then I'll meet you over at Able Sisters. Alright, let's see if they've got anything interesting in here. Oh, this is actually one of my favorite shirts. I love the purple. The blue is also not bad. I'm going to get the purple one. And let me see if there's anything else that I might like. Not my favorite jeans. Anything else look interesting? They got my sneakers. But I think that's probably it. I'm going to go ahead and just buy this, and then I'll go find a wardrobe and see if we can make a cute outfit out of it. Okay, so now that... Oh, my shirt matches my floor. All right, so now I have this room, the back room, and this left room. I'll tell you what, I'm gonna go ahead and literally like basically take up everything out of here, and let's see if we can decorate a little bit in my house today. So give me just a minute to put some stuff in my storage so it makes it a little easier for decorating, and I'll be right back. Okay, I've been playing around with furniture a little bit. Let me see if I can figure out if I've even got something to use for my walls and my floor based on the type of design I ended up going with. That might work. Um, Let's see. No, not that. I may end up just going with the white and then looking for a better wall that goes with what I ended up going with. That's not bare. That's not too bad. Let me make sure I don't see a floor that looks better. I think, ooh, hold on. This might actually work. Okay, so here's what we got going on. Let me, I've got a hot mess in my pockets. So I went online and found a couple of cute codes. So I kind of went crazy designing stuff, but I love the natural wood furniture in here. I just like natural wood in general. It's one of my like just favorite things. This room is definitely not going to be completely filled whatsoever. But I just thought I'd at least find a couple of cute items to put in here. Maybe there. I don't know what I'm doing. Wrong place. And then let's see. I really wanted to use this rattan bed, but I thought you could customize the bedding on it, but you can't. You can on the ranch furniture, but not that one. So there's that. All right, let's see if I have anything else here. I have this little sink. Maybe we can just put it over here. This is very, very slim pickings. But that's okay. It's a work in progress. Oh, here, we can go ahead and put this in here. And I could put the study desk in here. Let me see if I see anything else that looks like it might work. We can put a chiffonier tree in here. Anything else look like it might fit? And we can put some of these in here. And a book. Maybe a globe. Okay, let's see if I can do something with this. So we have a little study desk. The study desk is a little bit darker than I would like. But that's okay. I can make it work. We can set this right here. We can put the globe up here. And we can put the book on here. See if I can get it going the right direction. And we'll just stick the tree right there. Okay, it is better than nothing. It's at least a start for my bedroom. I should probably go make a chair to actually put over here. But yeah, that's a start for this room. It's not terrible. Okay, so here's my main room. I know I don't have a lot of furniture to go in here. I know we have the sofa. I really wish I had this in white. In a couple of days, I'll be able to unlock Harv's Island, and that will help a lot because I would also like to have this in here, and it needs to be a different color. So let me do this. I'm just going to place this furniture here, knowing that it needs to be changed. I don't know that I have a whole lot that's going to go in here, but it's at least a start. All right, so we have this, and I hit the wrong button. By the way, in case you didn't know, you cannot hit the B button like when you run to make decorating go any faster. I do it all the time. I'm like, can I get there faster if I use the B button? No, you cannot. All right, let me see how I want to do this. Let's put this here, and we'll just put our chair here. And we'll put our little table back there. Here, we'll just put the tree here. And I think I have my little rug somewhere. This is super, super simple. There we go. All right, that's what we got for now. At least I can say I am trying to decorate my house. Let's go see if we can set up a couple things in the kitchen. Okay, I think I got at least something on the floors, on the wall. We're gonna put a table in here. I need some chairs. Oh, I really need to do something with that and decorate it. Here's a little serving cart. We got a refrigerator. We got a stove. What else we got that can go in here? We got this scale. I got more stuff to go in here than I do any other room of the house. A kettle. This. Okay. That'll work. It is better than nothing. Oh, I can put these on the wall. Okay, so there's that. And as I say, this is just to kind of get stuff in here. This is by no means a final decoration of this. So let's see what we can do here. Really need to get some more like tables and stuff for in here. That would probably help. Oh, I know. We can put this on here. Lots of people use these little carts for their microwave. And this can go, well, that's fine. And really don't have anywhere to put the knife block, so we're just going to do this for now. That's fine. I don't care really. This was just to get some stuff in the proper rooms and I can fix it later. All right, let's go see what else we can get into on the island. Okay. So right here is where Nooks and Abels is going to go. And what I want to be able to do is have like a little, this little brick path coming out this direction. And then I want to be able to put like a little centerpiece area in here. So this really needs to be moved back quite a bit. And let me, I'm going to pull up on my other screen, like my little screenshot I did. Okay, so my plan is to keep the river over here. So let me think. I may end up moving this bridge. Like right over here would be perfect. So let me see. Where does this go? If I go this direction. Oh, it doesn't line up very well with that. All right, where does this line up? If I go this way, at least kind of line up. So it's in line with the bridge. Okay. All right, so we're gonna leave that alone. Or at least it's close to being lined up with the bridge. All right, so right in here is where I really do want these. I'm trying to decide how far back I want to put Nook's Cranny. Because I want to go ahead and move it while I've got like an extra day in here. And I think I literally want to move it back this far. So I have plenty of room to create some sort of like, I don't even know what to call it. Maybe a like a centerpiece area, courtyard type area, in front of these two buildings. And I would love it even more if I had like a way to put a road between them. So my plan is to move Abel Sisters, I think, back a little bit more. So I want at least four spaces between these two. Let me do this. Let's start with some, no, that's not what I want. This, with some design codes. So here's my brick stuff. Let's just pretend that I'm trying to make this four wide to go in between the buildings. If I do that, it means I want Nook's Cranny to start right here if I move it backwards. Okay, do I have anything to eat in my pockets? I do not. Let me go pick some fruit somewhere or a pumpkin over here or something, so that I can dig up this tree and I will be right back. Okay, I think I got this figured out. So here is the middle part where I want like the little road to go between the two buildings. Oh, this is, I think, gonna work absolutely perfect. Okay, so there's the road that's gonna go between them. It might not be here exactly. It might be back there. But that's okay. I'm fine with that. And I think this is gonna be back far enough that I have plenty of room to do something in front of here. So I think right here is where I want to put Nook's Cranny. So let me go get it and I'll be right back. Okay, here we go. All for nothing. Let's see, where's the center? I think this is it. So let's go ahead and try putting this here. It should work perfectly. I'm going to imagine it just to make sure. I think that'll work just fine. So let's go with it. All right, very cool. I may go ahead and like try to go ahead and put the little road in right here. So my plan is to have a little road going through here. I'm probably going to get rid of some of this water over here and then just do some terraforming maybe, or just make a lake back there instead of the river. Because I want a good bit of grassy area back in here instead of all of this. Because I'm wanting to do like a little maze, like a corn maze type of thing back here. And like a little festival type of thing. I thought that would be really cute back here. So I have a lot of terraforming to do in order to make that happen. But I think this little brick road would look really cute right here going back behind it. So I may go ahead off camera. And let's see if we can go ahead and extend this out towards the little bridge. We'll get Nook's moved today, and then I have a feeling I'm going to have to move Able Sisters twice. Because I really don't think this is enough room to just move it backwards. So, unfortunately, it's probably going to have to be moved twice, but I think we have enough time to do that. With tomorrow being the KK concert, I can really start terraforming. And that is really going to be our sign to really start decorating. And doing roads will be a lot easier than placing each individual path. I do want to show you a little bit of what I've done up towards the campsite. So give me a minute and I'll be right back. Okay, so the brick path that I'm using down there actually comes with some other pieces that make it look like a little ruined path. I think I like this, but I'm not sure. I may go in and change it out for something different, or I may just end up using the dirt path in here. Just not sure what I want, but I thought I'd show this to you. I just think it's kind of cute, and I'm probably gonna try to leave this little rock up here and then just find a cute way to decorate on my way over to my campsite. But for now, let's go ahead, just so we can try and get a couple more houses done. Let's go to Happy Home Paradise, and I'll meet you there. Okay, here we are, and there are a couple of items here I really want. This is one of them. This will be perfect for decorating outside of Able Sisters. And this is another really good item. The footrest that I could use because it won't be too much longer. We should be able to get Reese and Cyrus. So yeah, that works out really well. All right, let me go ahead and decorate a house, and I'll let you see it when I'm done. Okay, it took me a little bit, but I think I got this the way I want it. I thought it turned out really good. I'm trying to really work on my interior decorating skills, which are absolutely terrible. And with the limited amount of items I do have right now for decorating, I think this turned out pretty good. So let me finish this, and I will probably do one more house because, you know, in a roundabout way, I'm trying to, like, you know, speed run this without actually speed running it. Cause I just don't have it in me to come in here and literally just be like, yeah, here's the three items, you're good. I just can't do that. But anyway, let me finish this up and I'll see if I can do one more house. Okay, so I got done and Lottie let me know that Nico wants to talk to me. So I'm guessing, that this is about the DIYs. Yep, he found the DIY bottle. So, since I'm already out of my clothes, I'm probably not going to bother doing another one today. So, let me get through this and I'll meet you back at the island. Okay, I am back at the island and I went ahead and put this brick path in. Oh my gosh, this has become like my new absolute favorite path to use. I am like obsessed with it. And there's other pieces that go with it that are so cool that I may have to try to like figure out how to use them on this island because I absolutely love them. I really hope I got Nook's Cranny back far enough. I hope I did. I'll just have to figure it out once I'm able to play with this. Because if I want the path to be 4 wide going all the way around, I don't know that I have enough room. I'm really tempted to go see what other pieces are with this path that would work. Or I may just end up using a dirt path through here. I just have to figure out what I want to do. But yeah, this is like my new favorite dirt path that you can get. Or brick path. But anyway, I think for now, that's probably going to be it for today. I really can't think of anything else I can do. Tomorrow, on the other hand, is like pedal to the metal, all the way to the floor. Let's really start doing this. I'm excited about getting this island really going the way I want to. It's not going to be too much longer. I need to go ahead and take this stuff up here so I can really work on my entrance. So yeah, we got a lot of work to do. But I'm very happy with the progress of the challenge, and I feel like I'm up to it and we'll be able to do really good stuff with it. But for now, please be sure to like and subscribe, and I hope to see you next time. Bye-bye!